I see you gather before me. Hungry, terrified, clutching your babes to your breast. Emperor Emir has marched his legions into our lands, laid siege to every fortress from here to the Blue Mountains. Rabid and ravenous, he bites and bites away. Men of the North! You stand at the precipice. Your kings have failed you, so now you turn to the gods. And yet you do not plead. You do not kneel to dust your heads with ash. Instead, you wail, why have the gods forsaken us? We must look into the trials we failed long ago. In a time past, our world intertwined with another through an upheaval scholars call the conjunction of the spheres. The gods allowed unholy forces to slip into our domain. The offspring of that cataclysm was the nefarious force called magic. Yet we did not banish it, instead studying the vile arcane for our own power and wealth. And the monsters at our door, the unholy relics of this conjunction. The trolls, the corpse-eaters, the werewolves. Did we raise our swords against them? Or have we laid this burden on others? On so-called witches. Stray children taught the ways of foul sorcery, their bodies mutated through blasphemous ritual. Sent to fight monsters, though they could not distinguish good from evil. The flicker of humanity, long extinguished within them. Yes, their numbers have dwindled through the years. But a few still roam our lands, offering their bloody work for coin. To this day, they shame us with their very existence. The North bleeds, flogged by war. The battles are the gods' whip, chastisement for our sins. And let us not forget the terrors, the scourges from beyond our world. The Wild Hunt rides the sky with every full moon. The Dark Raiders abduct our children into lands unknown. Some say they herald a second conjunction. Can we chart a course back into the light? Will we find the strength to banish the mages from our kingdoms? Unite around the warmth of the eternal fire. Nigh is the time of the sword and axe. None will fight this war in our stead. Nigh is the time of madness and disdain.
Even now, I don't find that amusing.
It wasn't meant to amuse, but to prod you to hurry. It's midday already. You promised Ciri you'd train with her. Go before Vesemir bores her to death with those etchings.
So, later then.
See you later.
Got any clothes that aren't black or white?
Undergarments.
See, I thought Ciri could stand to wait a little longer.
It's uninstructive, not to mention unreasonable.
I don't want to be reasonable.
Aha, so that's the way the wind blows. Go and train with her, then come back. It'll give me a chance to put my face on.
Of all the women I've known, you're the only one who does that before.
You've known many.
What's it matter? Only ever thought of you.
I know. You might bring me some more once you're done training.
Shit. Mountain Pass is beautiful as ever. Witcher's fast asleep. Ciri's disappeared somewhere, of course. guess she prefers practice to theory.
What?
Time to wake up, Master. These lessons so boring they put you to sleep too?
Damn it. After taking notes on ghouls and al-ghouls, wanted to rest my eyes a bit.
Making her slog through that brick? No wonder she took off.
John of Bruges lacks flair, true, but he's reliable. Not like the hogwash they print nowadays. She's tackling the pendulums, right? How many times do I have to tell her? Don't train alone. It only embeds your errors. Bring our young damsel to the lower courtyard. She wants to practice, she'll get to practice.
Don't get mad at her.
Why the hell not? The whippersnapper refuses to do as she's told.
You like that about her?
Fine. I suppose I'm partly to blame. But this has to end. Now. Killing monsters is not something to be taken lightly. Ciri must understand that, if she's to become one of us. I'll see you below.
Wrong. Now I see why you were so eager to practice. Strike! Footwork. Enough. Get down.
With a flip?
What do you think? All right. Take off the blindfold. You've got work to do. Your reflexes are still slow.
Maybe for a witcher.
Think drowners or striggers will go easy on you because you haven't undergone the mutations? Though in your shoes, I'd fear Vesemir more than any Strigga. Disobeying his instructions? Unwise.
Well, yes, but that book was horribly dull.
I know, and you know that's no excuse.
I'm sorry. It won't happen again.
Better not. Vesemir said if it does, he'll make you eat a bowl of slugs covered in salt.
You!
Exactly. So you'd best behave. Come on, we'll practice with the others down below.
Shall we run the walls?
Of course. Is a witcher school or an elven bathhouse?
Beat you to the bottom!
Maybe if you fall. What did I tell you about breathing? Through your mouth, in rhythm with your steps.
Anything to say for yourself, young lady?
I'm very sorry, Uncle Vesemir.
Young blood craves action, I understand that. But when you fight a beast, knowledge counts as much as your silver sword. At the very least, you ought to be able to tell a ghoul from an al-ghoul.
By markings, like unto the panthera tigris that in Zeracania dwells, and by the sickly paleness of its visage.
So you did read the chapter. Still, you should have asked if...
But you were asleep, Uncle Vesemir.
Don't try to weasel your way out of this.
A witcher must know how to trick his opponent. You said so yourself.
Might have. But don't use my words of wisdom on Vesemir, got it? That's playing with fire.
Fine, we've talked enough. Geralt, you're with me, Lambert with Eskel, Ciri with a dummy.
Again?
Stop groaning and grab a sword. What do you think? Should we start by reviewing the fundamentals or go right to free training?
Should work on the basics. Even skilled masters need to hone the fundamentals, and Ciri's barely a novice.
Draw your sword, Geralt! We'll talk later. Quick cuts. 1, 2, 3. Strong strikes now. Give it all you got. Never lock your elbow when striking, young lady.
It's not too late to surrender. Position, Ciri. Footwork. Remember.
Ciri, see how Geralt holds his sword, its angle.
What am I supposed to carry? Stupid dummy.
Pretend now, live later. Riposte! Strike! Counter-strike! Now, young lady, to bring the day to a close, we'll go over a few witcher's signs. Let's start with Quen. Ciri, Quen is sometimes called the Witcher's Shield. Now watch carefully to see why. Cast Igni, Geralt. I want to see sparks fly. If not for the Quen sign, I'd be aflame by now. All right, Geralt, come on! See that, Ciri? Ard will knock anyone or any... Time for Axie. Damn it, I hate this feeling. Axie can really muddle your mind. Erda now. Show her, Geralt. See this, Ciri? Couldn't move if I wanted. Throw a bomb. Don't worry, Ciri. Quen will dampen the blow. Yeah. Fine. Enough. Continue training at will.
Showed him, kid.
Siri, get down here.
A little she-devil. Soon as she's back, we'll set her to polishing all the swords at Kaer Morhen.
Find that helmet. Siri?
Make sure to find every last blade for you. What that?
You all right?
Had a nightmare.
About?
Take forever to explain.
Dawn, some way off. We've got time.
Started in the guest room at Kaer Morhen. I was relaxing in a tub, and next to me...
Triss?
Yennefer. Funny, isn't it? She's never been there. Seemed so real in my dream, though.
Was she nagging you about something? True to life, indeed. We'll find her.
In the dream, I went and found Siri. Then we trained.
Those were the days. Little she-devil. I've trained kids who were faster, stronger, but none had her character. Didn't end well, did it, your dream?
No. A wild hunt appeared, attacked Siri. I couldn't move, stood there like a stump.
It was just a dream.
That's the problem. It was more. In the past, when Siri'd appear in my dreams, something was wrong. She was in danger.
We taught her how to defend herself from anything, wraiths included.
Be dawning soon. Time to go.
Wait. Show me the letter from Yennefer. Might have overlooked some hint in there.
Didn't overlook anything. We were meant to meet in Willoughby. That's what she wrote. Meanwhile, one army or another burned the village to the ground. All we can do is follow her trail, so...
Stop talking for a minute and give me the letter. Oh, how about that? It does smell of lilac and gooseberries.
We're gonna read it, not sniff it.
We must meet soon. Willoughby near Vizima. Nothing else to guide us there. What's this postscript? I still have the unicorn? Yeah.
stuffed unicorn. Used it once or twice. In certain situations.
The things young folk get up to these days.
Back on topic. How's it look? How far behind Yennefer are we?
2 or 3 days. Trail's fresh. But it looks like it leads towards the main road. Could be muddled there. Wait. Hear that?
I smell it. Ghouls.
Past necrophages. Sorry. Let's go before any more show up.
About this sorcerer I knew, couldn't stop talking about how useful they are as creatures.
Because you can brew potions from their blood?
No, because by eating rotting corpses they prevent epidemics.
Did he know they eat the living as well?
No, really upset him too. His theory collapsed. Slow now, whoa.
War is not exactly going our way.
We have a side.
The Northern Realms.
Radovid's realms, don't you mean? Temeria and Edirne are no more.
Radovid's pledged to restore the old borders as soon as he wins the war.
Believe that?
Gotta believe something. It's what keeps us going.
Hey there.
Going?
Help me! Help!
Has it gone?
Yeah. Come out.
Gods, that was close. I was sure I'd end up like my mare.
Provided you got lucky.
Your horse died quickly, but griffins like to toy with their prey. Eat it, alive, piece by piece.
Oh. You'd like a reward, I suppose.
Could always use a few crowns.
Thing is, I've a meager purse at the moment. Nilfgaardians requisitioned my goods. Now this? Here.
Back to the trail.
Like I said, leads to the main road and ends there, muddled.
You seek someone?
Yes, a woman. Medium height, long black hair. Seen anyone like that?
No. But there's an inn here in White Orchard. Sole one around. Gets its share of travelers. Perhaps you'll learn something there?
Not a bad idea. Especially since that wound needs cleaning.
Ah, beast barely grazed me. But sure, could use a good rye. Nice and cool, you know. Straight from a cellar.
Let's go.
That's it, Roach.
So, a griffin this close to the village? Strange.
My thoughts exactly. In the forest or the mountain, sure, but here? Near the main road.
Maybe it's the war. Corpses everywhere, the stench of blood, burnt flesh. Drives monsters crazy sometimes.
Men, too. We need to watch ourselves in White Orchard. And we should leave as soon as we...
What? Take that down before there's trouble.
That is a coat of arms, the Temerian lilies. They've a right to hang there.
This ain't Temeria no more, old man. It's Nilfgaard now.
My arse it is.
Witches.
I'll not drink with Weaver Lost freaks.
Beg your pardon for those thugs.
No need. We're used to it.
Folk are jumpy around here. Army's just passed through. Now a griffin's prowling about.
Already had the pleasure. One mean beast.
Mean? Light way for a hunter to put it. Clawed Lena so bad, poor thing's one foot in the grave. But there's no good to wallow in misfortune. How can I be of service?
With a drop of vodka for me.
And you? Something to wet your tongue.
Looking for a woman. Raven-haired, violet eyes, dresses in black and white, riding in from Willoughby. And, strange as it sounds, lilac and gooseberries might have smelled that.
I've not seen nor smelt such a lady. Believe I'd remember.
Yeah, especially hard to forget this one.
Plenty of travellers about, though. Folk from all over. Might be worth your while to ask after her.
There a contract on that griffin?
Nay, not at the moment. Used to be. Soon as a beast had built a nest nearby, the alderman would start a collection, or go to the Lord for help. Now the alderman don't use the privy without asking the Black One's permission first. And seems they hanged the Lord. So no contract.
Shame. We might have done something, but not for free.
Thanks for everything. Help you bandage that up?
Please. I'm not decrepit yet.
Then I'll ask about Yennefer.
Mm-hmm. Just remember, we'd rather not draw any attention.
Here. Black One's been out measuring the fields.
I'm looking for someone.
And we seek some peace and quiet.
Out of my face, freak, for your breath sours my beer.
Dressed in black and white. Seen her? Talk.
Folks say the lady rode through the village a few days back. Galloping so fast she knocked Radabor into a ditch.
Which way did she go?
Dunno. Lots of tracks leading off the main road. Could have gone anywhere.
Oi, people! The freak's taken Micah's mind!
Uh-huh. And I'll take your tongue if you don't shut up.
There are four factions.
Four what?
What a waste of time. The Earth shall revolve around the sun before you comprehend these rules.
Got a minute?
Why not? Aldert Geert, assistant professor in contemporary history at Oxenfurt Academy.
Geralt of Rivia, witcher with tenure. I'm looking for a woman. Long hair, dressed in black and white. Seen anyone like that?
Of course not. Unlike the populace, I know the horsewoman of war is pure poppycock.
Horsewoman of war? What's that about?
Folks say an omen. A beautiful phantom rides the fields at night, looks as you described her. Armies follow her and meet with misfortune.
I can vouch for the last bit. Know where they saw her?
No, facts interest me, not fairy tales.
Not a place I'd ever expect to find a scholar. Take it you're fleeing the war?
Quite the opposite. Chasing it. I'm headed for the front.
Tired of life?
I seek knowledge, which I value more than life itself. I've a thirst no dusty old tomes can quench. I wish to see the Nilfgaardian invasion with my own eyes, understand it, and record it all in my chronicle, my magnum opus.
Interesting. We need somebody to describe war, what it's really like. Not colorful banners and generals making moving speeches, but rape, violence, and thoughtless cruelty.
Ah, I see you lack the polish of the Academy. Rape and cruelty are details of no import to the war's course. Trinkets on the garment of conflict, one might say.
Tell that to the people whose houses burned down. Gotta go. So long.
A moment, Witcher. You strike me as a man of the world. Are you familiar with Gwent?
No, and I don't have time to learn.
But the rules are quite simple. Come, let's play.
Why not?
Splendid! Here's how it's done. Well, you've a knack for this game. If you ever find yourself in Oxenfurt and wish to play a true master, ask for Stepan. A simple innkeep by trade, but a true maestro when it comes to Gwent.
I'll remember that. Thanks. Looking for a woman.
Like everyone.
Not like everyone. And not just any woman. Mine smells of lilac and gooseberries, dresses in black and white.
Two schnappsies. It'll lift your spirits.
Fine, I'll have a drink. Can we cut to the chase? You seen her or not?
Yennefer of Vengerberg.
Never mentioned her name.
Yet you described her perfectly. And once I hear something, I never forget. Can't help it.
How do you know Yennefer?
What a question. Master Dandelion's ballads, of course. The only way a humble merchant might hope to rub up against greatness. Unless, that is, he's as lucky as I am.
And runs into a very patient witcher.
It's a Geralt of Rivia himself, the Butcher of Blaviken.
You seen Yennefer?
Deepest apologies, but I must ask, is this about love?
None of your business.
Yes, as a vagrant, I deserve no explanation.
What do you know? Tell me.
Before you appeared, it never occurred to me that might have been Yennefer. Who would have thought?
Get to the point.
An Ilfgaardian scout from the local garrison saw her.
Where?
At their camp. She rode in there. Dark of night. Black and white. Gooseberries and... Yes, I know. Had a terse exchange with the garrison commander and raced off.
Where to?
I'm not omniscient. Ask at the garrison.
Thanks.
We men of the road must stick together. Perhaps one day I'll be in trouble, and you'll be nearby to help.
Done drinking? Then fuck off.
Don't want your kind here.
Haven't done anything to you, so just calm down.
Of course not. You done nothing.
Horses working witchcraft. Get him!
Not your lucky day.
That's it, Roach.
He bumped his head when he went to bed and wet himself the morning.
Well, where's Elsa get her coin, I ask? She'll give tail to Blackens, I'm telling you.
Move it.
You're not to play with Chetty.
Not so fast, yes. Roach.
What? Up and smoke!
What happened here?
Oh, got a wee bit chilly the night, so I set fire to my forge. Got it nice and roaring. Roasted some wieners. What do you think happened, dimwit? Some bugger set alight me workshop. I've lost everything. Everything!
Sorry. Any suspects?
Whole damned village. I've lived here half a century. Thought they saw me as one of their own. But everything changed when the Black Ones came. The only smith around, so I got to service the garrison. Bang dents out of plate, shoe horses. That sort of thing. Nilf guardians don't pay me a bloody copper. Just give me supplies and orders. The humans can't fathom that. They think I'm getting rich off their misfortune. That I sleep on a pile of gold like a ploughing dragon. They've stopped talking to me. Spit when I pass. And now this.
I can find your arsonist, provided you're willing to pay.
I've not much left, but I'll give you all if you bring me that horse in. So that he gets what he deserves. The night of the fire, I heard movement outside my hut. Went out to see if I could find any tracks, but found nothing. But then I haven't got cat eyes, have I? Good luck.
That's it, Roach.
party, not like before.
Where's Elsa get her coin?
Kings do the fighting. Peasants do the...
Go, go. Come on now.